Hello, and thanks for watching Proactive New York. Bridgeline Digital has announced financial results for its fiscal third quarter ended June the 30th. With all the details, I'm joined by the company's President and CEO, Ari Kahn. Ari, very good to speak with you today.
Nice to see you, Stephen.
So, Ari, it looks like it was a pretty good quarter with revenue and gross profit both rising strongly. Take us through some of the financial highlights.
Great, great. We had 22% year-over-year for revenue growth, and a big portion of that was our SaaS revenue. Today, SaaS revenue accounts for 80% of our total revenue and is a 70% gross margin. Hawksearch is our number one selling product, and that's driving a lot of our growth. A small portion of our growth was inorganic from two acquisitions that we did last year, but most of the growth was organic growth driven by Hawksearch, which is growing at 19% CAGR.
Your gross margin also improved to 70%, and that was from 65% in the comparable period. Is this a feature we're going to see continuing, Ari?
It will. It will. So the gross margin is driven by our ratio of SaaS to professional services revenue. Professional services tends to have around a 40% gross margin, and our SaaS revenue tends to have around 75%. So when you blend the two together, it's 70% right now. And as our strategy is to have our products become increasingly out of the box and require less professional services, you'll see that margin increase as our percentage of total revenue attributed to SaaS increases.
You noted that during the quarter, you closed 23 license sales. So this cross-sales strategy looks like it is strong at the moment.
It's great. We call our strategy e-commerce 360. And the heart of that strategy is that we help customers grow their online revenue by driving more traffic to their website and increasing the conversion ratio of that traffic into buyers, and then increasing the average order value for each of those buyers. This strategy is centered on us having a large suite of products, different products that can improve traffic conversion or average order value. And by having that large set of products, that means that within our existing customer base, we are cross-selling products, and that's driving a lower customer acquisition cost because there's no marketing expenses associated with selling to our existing customer base. There's a second component to the e-commerce 360 strategy. The first component I described is for organic growth. We seek to have more efficient organic growth because part of our organic growth is from selling to existing customers in addition to winning new customers. The other part of the e-commerce 360 strategy is inorganic growth. And on the inorganic side, we in the MarTech space happen to live in, I would say, an overpopulated environment. There's 10,000 apps in the e-commerce space, and most of these apps are really individual products. They're not companies, and they are better suited to be part of a larger business. We did two acquisitions last year. We're continuing to evaluate acquisition opportunities. And when you combine our more efficient organic growth with the fact that we're in a target-rich environment for inorganic, we expect to see outstanding growth from the combination of both of these in our e-commerce 360 strategy.
Ari, you mentioned Hawksearch and how popular that was. And you mentioned negotiated a $600,000 discount to the final earnout on the Hawksearch acquisition. So tell us about that.
Sure. When we do acquisitions, we're typically paying between 1 and 2 times revenue, with half of the payment upfront and the other half 1 or 2 years later, as a ratio of the total retained customers from the acquisition date. When we took a look at Hawk, we understood the future, what the future earnout was going to be. All of the customers were going to stay, and we had removed all of the integration risk. We spoke to the Hawksearch buyers, and in today's bear market, they felt that they would prefer to have $2 million of cash in hand to invest in the market rather than wait until January for $2.6 million. We thought that was a good deal on our side, and it was a win-win, so we negotiated the early payment.
New customers over the period: Sage Publishing, True Presence, Pharma Direct, a number of new customers signed up.
That's right. That's right. Sage Publishing is an excellent customer of ours because they have several subsidiaries, including Corwin Press. And as we're deploying our search product through Sage Publishing's website, we also have opportunities to expand our footprint within Sage into each of its subsidiaries. Pharma Direct is a European pharmaceutical retailer with online sales, and we help their customers more easily find the products that they want to buy. And they happen to be using a product called SIM of ours, or no, excuse me, it's Procon pumps that use SIM. SIM is Search Information Management. And this is an important and unique feature in our software. When people are looking for a product online, especially in the B2B environment, the descriptors for that product, such as if I'm buying a bolt, is it going to be a 10 millimeter or a quarter inch bolt, can have different units of measure. And what SIM does is it automatically does those conversions so that your customers are more likely to find what they're looking for. But it goes beyond just the mathematical conversions that you might see in converting metric to English measurements, and uses an AI algorithm to identify subjective measurements, where one person might call something blue and the other one might call it azure, for example, and is able to make those conversions as well to increase the revenue for your website.
Then also, you've announced a number of partnerships. Take us through the rationale for the partnerships and what you get out of this.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's another important part of the e-commerce 360 strategy. A year ago, our revenue was primarily driven by a platform called Unbound. And that platform caused us to be competitors with Sitefinity, with BigCommerce, with Kintico, strong and entrenched companies. We stepped back in the e-commerce 360 strategy and said, we don't want to be competitors, we want to be partners. And we shifted our focus to create apps that are compatible with each of these other platforms and to dissect our own platform and break it into components so that it's no longer compatible, but instead provides unique capabilities that can extend their platforms. So in this way, Sitefinity, BigCommerce, Kintico act as a foundation, as a operating system and database for an e-commerce website. And we act as the app on top of it, where after you've created a website, if you want to add a extended search module or a impulse purchase recommendation on a checkout screen, we add that. We create greater value for our partners' customers by giving them features that they would normally have to build themselves. We create value for our partners by helping their customers stay on their platform longer. And overall, this is a big part of our recent growth.
Ari, after a strong third quarter, how's the fourth quarter looking so far?
Going forward, we're expecting to continue to see growth, especially in the subscription area. And we're expecting to continue to have positive cash flow from operations, which is going to allow us to continue to invest in sales and marketing and to build the company organically and only do acquisitions when they're the perfect fit for Bridgeline.
Well, I'm sure we're going to be chatting again very soon, but thank you very much for the update today.
Thank you, Stephen.
Ari Kahn is President and CEO at Bridgeline Digital. We'll be right back.